Hello, I am Puri, Virakarin from Rayong, Thailand.
And I am Natthakan, Saengnil from Rayong, Thailand.
We will present our new project, Application of Machine Learning Technique, Assisted Prediction of Bioactivities of Ligands in Targeted Drug Discovery Process of Lung Cancer for EGFR Target. Our project focuses on developing machine learning models to discover more effective drugs against cancers for epidermal growth factor receptor or EGFR family proteins. Since this is a 2-year project, it can be divided into two phases. And for the first phase, we focus on lung cancers.
Lung cancer in non-smoker who suffer from increasing in amplification or hyperactivation of the EGFR gene. EGFR acts as a stimulus for sending a signal in cell division. Consequently, a high number of cell divisions occur, which is one of the cancer behavior. From the above problem, doctors or researchers need to find effective drugs for lung cancer treatment. This drug will work by decreasing the activity of EGFR. However, the standard drug discovery process requires 15 to 20 years, more than $2 billion per drug. Currently, the popular method for helping the drug discovery process by using computer is virtual screening techniques. One of them is the molecular docking technique, which gives the binding affinity score between ligand and targeted protein. However, it still performs at low efficiency and requires a lot of computation time. Nowadays, machine learning has overcome these problems. From the literature review, we found that there are already models that target EGFR, but their performances are not well enough. In addition, these models were trained with low amount of data. Therefore, we developed machine learning models for predicting PIC50 with large-scale dataset. PIC50 is the value that indicates the compound's potency in inhibiting a specific target. The principle of machine learning is to train the model by both input and output. Then the model will find relationship between these two. In this case, we use compound structures as an input and corresponding PIC50 as an output. And we have created machine learning models with three algorithms to compare their efficiencies.
This is the overview of our work. Firstly, we download about 90,000 bioactivity data from LeeAssist database. The data were collected from public researchers. It contained the structures of compounds and their experimental bioactivities. However, some abnormal and accurate data must be deleted, and Vietnam Viet allowed 3,000 data. After cleaning the data, we also remove outliers using the integral Thailand method. These bar charts show the data distribution before and after outlier deletion. The gap show that the data were normally distributed than the original dataset. And then, we convert mines, the thing that represent the structure of the compound, into fingerprints or binary representation. Afterward, these fingerprints were reduced in dimension to decrease the computation time and chance of overfitting. So, we use three techniques for dimensional reduction. And next, we create the machine learning models from three algorithms, which are random forest, CNN, and CSGN. Then, we try to optimize the model by changing the fingerprint pattern and tuning the hyperparameter to increase the efficiency.
Firstly, the random forest or RF was created from the scikit-learn package. This figure depicts an example of model structures. To find the best sets of features, we use RFE with adjusted R-square. RFE is the technique that can find suitable number of features to obtain the best model without overfitting. Then we plot the predicted versus experimental PIC50 value. It showed that our model can accurately predict the PIC50, and on the right hand side is the wide scamming plot which is used to measure model robustness. This was done by training the model with random data and test it with actual data. The results show that the fake model cannot predict the real data, so the original model is robust and didn't learn by chance. Next is convolutional neural network or CNN algorithm. For CNN and CSGN, we use PyTorch as a framework. This figure illustrates the CNN algorithm structure, which contains convolutional layers and fully connected layers. Different fingerprints were used as an input to each layer. We have used 12 fingerprints from the feature selection technique and 27 fingerprints from the PCA technique to be the input in each layer. This slide shows our best results with the CNN algorithm. The new graph is the loss curve, which is a plot between training loss and validation loss versus epoch. It can be seen that the validation loss doesn't increase when the training loss decreases, so the model was not overfitting.
Lastly, convolution spatial graph embedding neural network, or CSGN. The CSGN algorithm comprised of CSGE layers, fully connected layers, and convolutional layers. For CSGE layers, molecular structure was encoded into graph and was fed into this layer. But for the fully connected layers and convolutional layers, molecular descriptor was used as an input. The outputs from this layer were concatenated into the final molecular representation to predict the bioactivity. The CSGN development process is similar to the CNN, and these are our results. To conclude, CSGN models outperform the other algorithms, and we will call this model as the Ligand EGFR. Our Ligand EGFR model is the first model that was trained on a non-redundant and large-scale dataset. We then compare the efficiency between our machine learning model and the conventional molecular docking technique by doing a level compound skinning. We found that our machine learning model performed much better than the molecular docking technique and used less computation time. Besides, the applicability domain analysis showed that the Ligand EGFR model had a large chemical spaces, which means that the prediction from our models are reliable. And this is the end of the first phase.
For the second phase, we enlarge our scope from EGFR or HER1 protein to our EGFR family proteins, including HER1, 2, 3, and 4, and also HER1 mutant protein. EGFR family proteins are the causes of many cancers, such as breast, gastric, esophagus, lung, pancreatic, and bladder cancers. Besides, we include HER1 mutant because the current lung cancer drugs targeting wild-type HER1 can lead to drug-resistant mutations. Nowadays, multi-target drugs are used in various treatments due to their better therapeutic efficacy than targeted drugs. For example, in cancer treatment, some multi-target drugs targeting EGFR family proteins can bind with both HER1 and HER2. Therefore, we created machine learning models for discovering new multi-target drugs against all EGFR family proteins. However, there is a low amount of experimental data, so we decided to use transfer learning and multitask learning techniques to overcome these difficulties. Multitask learning is a technique that trains the model with all targeted proteins simultaneously, and transfer learning is a technique that transfers Ligand EGFR knowledge to new models.
Next is our procedures. We download bioactivity data from KMBL database. We then convert SMILE into fingerprints, which are the same as the Ligand EGFR model. After we had all the data we want, we created the models with four combinations, which are single task learning with transfer learning, multi-task learning with transfer learning. Lastly, we compare their performances with traditional machine learning, which are random forest and extreme gradient boosting. These are our outcomes. This graph illustrates the predictive performance comparison between our deep learning models and traditional machine learning models. We use RMSEs to compare the models. RMSEs is the root mean square error of the prediction. Therefore, the lower RMSEs, the better predictive performances. As per the chart, it can be seen that most of our deep learning models outperform traditional models as they show the lower RMSE value. However, there are some targets that the traditional one has a higher efficiency. The reason is that in these targets, the similarity to Ligand EGFR is low, so the transfer learning and multi-task learning techniques cannot be applied to this target because these techniques are based on principle of similarity between targets. To confirm implementation of our models, the heat map shows the prediction errors of the marketed drugs. These that are clearly used in liver cancer treatment, for example, the first HER1 mutant target showing on the fifth row. Our model can predict PSA50 of rosiglitinib gefitinib, afatinib, and ibrutinib with an accuracy of 0.01. In other words, all models effectively predict PSA50 of marketed drugs, so the model can be used in low compound screening.
We also plot the PRISM-A to reveal the chemical space of compounds in each targeted protein. The analysis showed that the similarity between the target and the ligand EGFR affects the transfer learning technique's efficiency, and the similarity among all targets impacts the efficiency of multitask learning technique. In conclusion, the first phase showed that the ligand EGFR models with graph representations yield a better performance than baseline algorithms, which are well-known for race, conventional neural network, and molecular logging technique. Then, we use the ligand EGFR as a core network in the next phase.
In this phase, the results show that our model can accurately predict the PSA50 of EGFR family inhibitors. Furthermore, the deep learning models with transfer learning and multitask learning techniques outperform traditional machine learning models. Lastly, our model provides powerful strategies that may potentially help researchers to discover novel drugs against EGFR family proteins. Moreover, this technique can also be applied to multi-target drug discovery for other targets with more scale experimental data. Thanks for watching.